Life moves pretty fast. You don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it.
One good thing about the COVID pandemic is that it is keeping us closer to home and that it brought back family dinner for many of us. This is one of the things that remains in what people refer to as a new normal, then I am all for it. This painting entitled Home Fries is a reminder that home is where the heart is, and the place our heart gets nourished most is around the dinner table. Now, in the last 100 years or so, we've seen technology bring about more advancements than the rest of human history combined. We've come a long way, baby. For the most part, these advancements have served us well. We're able to produce more food, travel longer distances in less time, eradicate once deadly diseases, and improve the length and quality of our lives. Unfortunately, we're so eager to reach for the new and improved that we often throw the wisdom of the ages right out the window. It's dangerous to be too quick to discard the traditions of the past as old-fashioned and out of touch. Now, one such tradition that seems to be going the way of the dodo bird is the family dinner. Our busy pack schedules have pushed this old-timey tradition to the brink of extinction. After all, with so many things going on these days, who has time to gather together all at once? And with such full plates, family dinner is often the first to go. The rise of fast food joints and microwave ovens have made it easy seem like an easy sacrifice. Unfortunately, the very thing we're sacrificing is the health, intimacy, and future of our family. As Miriam Weinstein wrote in her book, The Surprising Power of Family Meals, we've perfected the segmentation of the family. Nobody has to eat the same food, watch the same show, listen to the same song, let alone sing it. She says, we love to imagine the French with their lush tables or the Italians with their big families, but we prefer to gobble our takeout, our home delivery, our single-serve microwave on the run, in front of the TV, in the food court, or in the car, while we dream of quality time, of family vacations, of someplace far away. If you care at all about your family, you may want to reconsider the importance of family dinners in your life. The National Center on Addiction and Substance Abuse at Columbia University did a study that divided teenagers into two groups. The first group had dinner with their family 5 times a week or more. The second group had dinner together with their family 2 times a week or less. The results were astounding. They discovered that the kids who ate dinner more often with their families were up to 45% less likely to smoke, drink, use drugs, be suspended from school, or have sex at young ages. They're twice as likely to get A's. Kids who frequently eat dinner with their families are likelier to confide in their parents or at a lower risk for thoughts of suicide. Other studies from a wide variety of divergent fields have found equally surprising results. Regular family dinners discourage obesity and eating disorders and make kindergartners better equipped to read even more than getting read to. Isn't it amazing to think how much depends on dinner? Now, please note, we're not talking about gourmet dinners here. The study didn't say anything about preparing meals that would make Bobby Flay weep. And the conversation, it doesn't have to be all that engaging either. Heck, in my house growing up, a typical dinner conversation often included my dad farting and blaming it on a duck under the table, which resulted in giggles from me and my two brothers and an icy glare from my mom, which usually was concealing a nearly undetectable smirk. Oh, and my dad also had a penchant for asking the same stupid, boring question every single night. How was school today? Naturally, we'd respond with the same stupid answer. Fine. But the thing is, if by some freak occurrence something actually did happen at school that I wanted to talk about, I knew my dad and mom would be there to ask that question. That shared time together, that calm amidst the storm that we call life, is so vitally important. In a world that often seems like it's gone crazy, the best thing you can do for the health and sanity of your family is to step off the hamster wheel once a day and share a simple meal together. The conversations that do occur help parents to learn more about their kids' lives and help them to better understand the day-to-day challenges their kids are facing. And maybe regular family dinner time is tough to swing. Who says you can't make breakfast your regular meal time? If every parent knew how important eating dinner together as a family was to their children, something that used to be an unquestioned element of family life, I think we'd see a lot more people doing it. If you struggle finding time to corral the troops for mealtime on a regular basis, I encourage you. No, I beg you. Try harder. Not only is it a pretty good way to escape the hustle and bustle of the outside world for a few moments each day, the benefits it provides your kids are priceless. And if family dinners are already a part of your routine, good for you. Why not give it even more attention, intention, and fun? Life, it's pretty fast. Technology is making it even faster. Don't get so sucked into the promise of the future that you abandon a time-tested ritual that our ancestors knew to be vital. Bring the tradition of eating dinner together back into the fabric of your life. The health and happiness of your family depends on it.